cross for you and me. I will come again, my reward is with me, to give to everyone, to give to everyone according to his word. Behold, I'm coming soon. I will come again, my reward is with me, to give to everyone, to give to everyone according to his word.
Happy Sabbath, my primary friends. I hope you guys are okay and you're keeping safe. Yeah, so you want to pray so that you can begin our lesson. Let's pray. Our Father in heaven, we thank you because you love us. Thank you so much for another opportunity to study your word. We pray that the Spirit of the Lord is going to be with us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Yes, so last week's lesson was called Spreading the Word. Yeah, and it was from the book of Acts. Yeah, we've been learning about God's children in the book of Acts, the way they used to, you know, Paul and Barnabas in their journey and all that. And so today, our lesson is a bit different, but yeah, our lesson for today is called A Wife for Isaac. A Wife for Isaac, okay. So, and before we begin, I'm going to tell us our memory verse. Our memory verse comes from the book of Genesis chapter 24 verse 40. The Bible says, "The Lord will send his angel with you and make your journey a success." Yes, the Lord will send his angel with you and make your journey a success. And remember what I've told you, our lesson for today is called A Wife for Isaac. So guys, have you ever gone on a long journey? Like a very long journey, a long journey that started in the morning and then it ended in the evening. Yes, when you go to Ushago or when you're going for a school trip, yes, usually carry food. The teacher always tells you that you're supposed to pack your snacks and your food so that when you're hungry, you can always eat your food. Yes, so in the Bible, there's also someone who went for a long journey. And this guy, he was called Eliezer. Eliezer was a servant of Abraham. And do you know what he carried on his long journey? He carried 10 camels. 10 camels. You know camels? Yes. Ngamia ile refu. Yes. He carried 10 camels. And the 10 camels were supposed to help him to carry everything that he needed. Yes. So Eliezer had slept the previous night and it was suddenly morning and he needed to leave. Remember, our lesson is called A Wife for Isaac. So Eliezer was going on a mission. He had been sent by Abraham, who was his master, because now Isaac had become old enough to get married, and so he needed a wife. So in those days, your father could be able to get you a wife. I am not sure if it can happen today in 2020, but in those days, it used to happen. Yes, so Eliezer woke up in the morning, he prepared himself, he prayed, and then he started his journey. And Abraham told him that, "I know that the Lord is going to lead you." You see, Abraham wanted the son, Isaac, to marry a godly wife. Sindio, a godly wife is one who loves God, who goes to church, who takes the children to church, who teaches the children good songs. That's a godly wife. A godly wife does not go to clubs or to dance and to do all those other things during church. Yes, so those women where Abraham used to live. Do you know where Abraham used to live? Yes, Abraham used to live in Canaan. Yes, those Canaan, the women from Canaan were heathen women. Heathen women are women who do not know God. Yes, and that's why Abraham had to send Eliezer to go on this journey. And so Abraham told Eliezer, "Just go. God is going to lead you." So Eliezer went on this long journey. Remember, he was carrying his 10 camels. And he went. And he finally got to that place. Where he got to, that place was called Nahor. It was called what? Nahor. Yes. So when he got to Nahor, let me read for you what Eliezer was. There's a prayer that Eliezer made. Eliezer told God, "Lord God of my master Abraham. Give me success today. And then Eliezer told God, please keep your promise, my master. Imagine this guy had so much faith in God, and he asked God to give him success. I don't know if you guys have ever asked God to give you success on, you know, on a particular day, if you're going to do your exams, or, you know, you're going for this journey. Usually see mom and dad praying every morning before they go to work or when they're going for a long journey. So Eliezer asked God to give him success, that day. And then when he was praying, the Holy Spirit gave him an idea. The Holy Spirit told him to go to the well, where women used to fetch water. You see, in those days, people used to get water in wells. These days, you guys are lucky. You have tap water. You get water from the shower. Those days, people used to go to the well. Well, ni nini kwa Kiswahili? Kisima. So when they used to go to the well, like, women would go either very early in the morning or late in the evening. So this day, the women were supposed to come to the well. So Eliezer prayed. And you know what he told God? That this is the time that women are coming to fetch water. So the woman I will ask to lower his jar so that I can drink. And she will also ask me that if my camels can drink, that's the woman. Hey, do you know what happened? Immediately Eliezer finished his prayer, there is a young woman who was coming. And that young woman was very, very beautiful. Do you know her name? Do you? I will tell you before the story ends. So when this woman came to the well, she was beautiful. Alquam Supu. So when she got to the well, Eliezer asked her to lower her jar so that she could drink water from it. And she did exactly that. She was a very good woman. She lowered her well and Eliezer was able to drink. And then Eliezer asked, you know, and then she ended up saying the exact words that Eliezer had made in his prayer, that you bring also your camel so that I can bring them. So imagine, she gave water to all the 10 camels. And then after that, Eliezer asked that woman that, who are your parents? Please take me to your parents. Now at this point, I'm going to tell you the name of that woman. She was called Rebecca. Yes, we know from the Bible that the wife of Isaac was Rebecca. So Rebecca and Eliezer went to Rebecca's home, to their father. So when Eliezer knew who Rebecca's father was, he actually thanked God, because he was like, yes, this is a man of God. So when they went to the house, Rebecca was keenly listening to, you know, to what, you know, when Eliezer was telling the story to the dad, how he had been sent by Abraham to get a wife for Isaac, and how he had prayed to God, and how God had answered his prayer. At that point, the Holy Spirit convinced Rebecca that this was a man of God, and so she accepted to go back with Eliezer, and that is how Rebecca became the wife of Isaac. Imagine, just like that. Do you know how possible, how was that possible? It's because Eliezer trusted in God, and God was able to answer his prayer. And at this point, we are going to go back to our memory verse. Can you remember what our memory verse says? Yes, it's from the book of Genesis, chapter 24, verse 40. And the Bible says, the Lord will send his angel with you and make your journey a success. That is what Abraham told Eliezer. And surely God made Eliezer's journey a success. So my friends, today, that's an encouragement for us, that even us, we can ask God to bless us and to make our journeys of life a success. You know, our journeys of education, our journeys of just growing up. Every day before you leave home, make sure you pray and ask God to make your journey a success. And because God is faithful, he's going to answer your prayer. May God bless you, and I pray that you may all have a happy Sabbath. Let's pray. We are praying. Our Father in heaven, thank you because from your word we have seen that you made Eliezer's journey a success because he prayed and he believed in you. And so today as little children we want to ask you that you may teach us to ask you to bless our journeys, and because you are a faithful God, you are going to answer our prayers and make our journeys of life a success. Please continue being with us and help us to be good children and to be attentive, and bless us for the rest of the Sabbath. It is my prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Bye. God bless you. See you next Sabbath.